Hey, Orcs people. I've been asked a few times what I thought about the series on Netflix, Godless. So here's a scene from Godless, and the person who plays the head role in Godless is the same guy that played in Dumb and Dumber, and he does a pretty good job. He's an eccentric guy who claims to be like a pastor and a preacher. He does good things, and then he does really evil and bad things. One thing he does, he kills a whole town because they help a guy he's after. But anyway, here he is walking with a horse, and he explains about gentling a horse.
Beautiful country, ain't it? Good book says prosperity is the path to godliness. And if God wanted man to be poor, he wouldn't have surrounded him with so much bounty.
Which good book are you referring to?
Sure know how to pick fine horse flesh, son. You get to reading someday, you might come across a fellow named Xenophon.
Xenophon? Come on, Frank. Why don't you just admit you make this stuff up?
He's a Greek fellow, student of Socrates. Some say the first real horseman. Horses being prey animals and all. Greatest instincts.
Okay, so he's not making a guy up, and anybody that understands original horsemanship, etc., if they've read about history, they know that Xenophon is a Greek. He was a study under Socrates, and he was a Spartan, and he was a great warrior and a general and a leader and all kind of things. But he was kind of known as the first horseman, and people say he was the first natural horseman. Remember back in wars and everything, horses were valued and they were needed, and they took you into battle and they could save your life. So in some aspects, they were probably treated better than they are today because they're not just for luxury. So, but if you watch this, I'm going to go back a little on this video when you see him walking out here. And you notice this little pile right here. I'm going to call this a mark. So this horse has probably been out here and laid down several times before. So he's bringing him, and this is called association when you're training a horse or a dog. You bring him to an area of comfort. You do something several times in the same area, the same way, and then the animal associates that area with what you're doing. So I'm assuming a trainer took this horse over several times and had the horse lay down because the horse goes down pretty gentle. So he walks him over to this area, which is probably soft.
Good book says prosperity is the path to godliness.
He's in the dirt area.
And if God wanted man to be poor, he wouldn't have surrounded him with so much bounty.
He's got no bit. He's got a tied on rope halter. And he's leading him. He's already got the reins connected, which is how I say I ride today. No bit with a halter and just rope around the reins. I think this is doable. A lot of horses are started this way. A lot of horses are ridden this way. Bits are archaic pain devices. Most people who watch me know about bits. So let's get down to what he's going to do here.
Which good book are you referring to?
Here you'll notice he's doing probably the exact same routine that the trainer's done. You're going to walk him to this spot and you're going to spin him once or twice. He's leading him. He's got the other hand putting pressure on a horse's butt. And he's making a horse walk around him. Pretty basic lunging style.
Sure know how to pick fine horse flesh, son. You get to reading someday, you might come across a fellow named Xenophon.
And on my website, I have a little thing about Xenophon back. I think he died when he was 75. And now remember, a natural horseman back then, horses were kind of brutalized and kind of treated hard. So calling someone a natural horseman back in 431 BC just means he was probably kinder than most. He believed about the prey prey of a horse, the flight, the fight or flight. But he still believed in using a bit. The horse was used for war. They used stallions. They still used spurs and whips. So it wasn't like he was completely against. He just was probably one of the kindest guys around at the time, and he wrote some things about caring for horses and how horses shouldn't be beaten and shouldn't be treated rough and should be explained things and should be exposed to things. So, and I want to say the book that kind of quotes him a lot is called On Horsemanship or something, but there's some vague history about him and horses.
Xenophon. Come on, Frank. Why don't you just admit you make this stuff up?
He's a Greek fellow, student of Socrates. Some say the first real horseman. He believed that horses, being prey animals and all, greatest instincts, fear, flight, and lastly, fight. So on account of that, old Xenophon thought taming them made more sense than breaking them. Rather than hauling or beating the animal, he used a bit of rope, some gentle restraint.
Notice the dirt is very soft here. There's just a little hay ladle across it. They've made this very conducive for the horse to lay down, obviously for the movie. But this horse lays down pretty easy without a lot of assistance. I've laid down Buddy like this before. I'm sure there's a couple videos that I laid him down. But anyway, he just gets his horse to lay down here. And, I mean, I think he's doing a pretty good job on explaining and saying what's going on and, you know, using a rope and gentling the horse. Even today, I don't like when somebody says I'm breaking a horse, because breaking implies breaking the horse's spirit. And gentling or starting a horse tends to be you're working with the horse, etc. Now, you can call it starting a horse and have an idiot trainer who still beats the horse and does the other thing, but he just calls it starting because he fools the people that don't know. But if you're actually starting a horse, you expose him to things, you desensitize him, you get him used to laying down or picking up his leg or handling his feet or dropping his head or walking with you without a bit and all this other stuff. So there's a difference between gentling and starting a horse and breaking a horse. And it's not just terminology, although some people will just try to trick you and change their terminology and do the same thing.
Kindness. Do it that way. Not natural for a horse to be laid down. Makes him amenable but full of fear. Makes it hard for him to do what he wants to do, which is bolt. So he's got to trust you. Despite what some men think, not just about showing him who's boss.
Amen to that. Okay, I don't know if Xenophon said it that way, but I get so tired of showing a horse who's boss. I mean, when somebody comes over and starts screaming and yelling and telling somebody to do that, I automatically know they don't have a clue about real horsemanship.
About showing them that you're the ones going to feed him, water him. You're the one that's going to take care of him. It's about showing him he can trust you always and forever.
Okay, so he's kind of being a little aggressive here. I don't know if it's the same guy or if this is a stunt double that got on him. He's in his little spot. So the horse lays down and get on. He's getting mounted. He's turning him up. Right here, I think he's kind of being a little aggressive, what I would call hard on a rope. This horse isn't giving his head. Remember, a horse should follow his head. And when you see a horse with a stiff neck like this, even though he's turning, He's not following his head, and he's definitely not following it softly. But again, this is a movie, and they're trying to make the point, and the good music in the background makes it sound sensitive, and his words sound nice, and he's making a good point. There's quite a few other things in Godless about horses that are questionable, but it's great for Hollywood. And one of the scenes, and if I can remember to go back and do it, is where a guy's breaking a horse, and he lays him down, he's climbing on, he gets on him, and he rides him off, and the horses are broken, and like, and I say broken, but let's say they're started in less than 10 minutes. And that just doesn't work. And just because you lay a horse down, if you immediately jump on his back and think he's going to let you because you lay him down, that's not going to work. Laying a horse down, if it's not done with meanness and aggressiveness and tying a horse's feet together and yanking together and knocking him over, if it's done with, you know, cooperation with the horse, it does tell the horse to teach a little, to trust you. It allows the horse to understand that when I'm on the ground, you can approach me. It allows the horse to just grow in his trust that even when I'm on the ground, you're not going to immediately jump on me. Because if you jump on a horse every time he lays down, your horse ain't going to lay down on you. But anyway, this was a pretty good scene. I don't want to keep playing it because what happens next just really irritates me. But we'll end that there on Godless and this horse thing. But it was a good explanation of Xenophon, natural horse, etc., carrying on the old ways, trying to work with the horse, understanding the fight, flight, fear, all that response for the horse. So I thought it was a pretty good scene, and we'll end that there.